It's a beautiful day in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, and everyone is making butter soup. What are the ingredients to the butter soup?
4 pounds of butter and low heat.
Boil it now.
Hey, Dan. So we're going to clarify some butter today.
We're making ghee.
That's what the Indians call ghee. Yep, clarify.
I'm going to eat it with a spoon, like little Krishna. Look at it. So tell me more about this process. What's going to happen here now?
Well, let's...
What's in that? Oh,
first, let's just talk about butter for a little bit.
So I love this idea.
Butter isn't just fat. Butter has milk solids. It has some water that's residual from the butter-making process. And depending on whether or not it's salted butter, it could have some salt in it. So this is unsalted butter. This is 4 pounds of unsalted butter that I just picked up from Costco, super cheap. And what we're doing right now is just kind of boiling the water out of it. Now, the milk solids in the butter are what will make it burn. So butter is considered kind of a low smoke point
cooking
fat.
Mm-hmm.
So if you were... So I like to scramble eggs at a really high heat very quickly.
Mm-hmm.
And if you add the butter and get it too hot too quick... We've all seen how butter can burn.
I've certainly done that.
Certainly burned butter, right?
Mm-hmm.
So what's burning there isn't the fat, it's the milk solids inside the fat. And those are just mostly proteins and some milk sugars, lactose. So what's happening in the clarification process, we melt all of that out, and then we separate off the milk solids from the fat. And once the milk solids are separated from the butter fat, it's actually great for really high cooking application or high heat cooking applications. It has a tremendously high smoke point. I'd say probably as good or even better than, say, peanut oil.
Wow.
Which is certainly a great fat for high heat applications like stir frying.
Mm-hmm.
I've never seen anything really deep fried in clarified butter, but you could totally deep fry in butter, like clarified butter, and
yeah.
That might be really fun to
Let's do that. We should bread some turkey breasts and deep fry them in clarified butter.
Or like chicken tenderloins. You can use like crushed up pork. So we're trying to eat very low carb.
We're doing keto.
So, yeah, we're doing a ketogenic diet. The house, the three fat dudes going on a keto diet and quitting drinking for a month, I think.
I got to quit drinking.
It's going to be some... Yeah, I think there...
I'm excited.
It'll get tough and maybe sometimes, but I think the three of us can keep each other honest.
And sounds
good.
And
be a good support network. I think your cheese powder is burning.
Flaming cheese powder.
Maybe we could have cleaned up before we made a video, but...
Babadook. Wow, look, it's really boiling away the water. Is that how it works?
We're boiling off the water, that's right. And then the milk solids will kind of toast, and we'll be able to just pour the clarified butter right off the top of it. It works best in a tall, skinny container.
Now, how long does this process take?
You know, I've never timed it. It's not a quick process, but it's not like all day.
How do you know when it's done?
You'll see.
The bubbles have been through many phases so far.
But that's an excellent question, Dan. Glad you asked.
Thanks.
Well, that second pass that Brendan's always talking about, I figured I'd placate him.
Wow.
These are nice chairs.
There's a whole lot of new chairs.
That means we can get rid of those wicker ones I don't like.
Those are scary sometimes.
I don't like those at all. Not a fan of them.
What's your... Yeah?
Or rattan.
Oh, Bert Rattan. Oh, so what's it doing now? It looks really different, Alan.
Yeah, the bubbles change as you lose water. Something's happening now. Look. I don't know exactly what it is.
You think it's burning? You've never witnessed it do that before?
I've never seen it do that before, but I've never just cooked it kind of longer like this. I guess I'll get a spoon and scrape some of this off the top and see what's happening down on the bottom.
Let's taste a couple spoonfuls, Alan.
Well, I think we kind of want it to get toasty. We don't want it to burn. I don't know if they'll burn.
We're screwed. Oh, man.
Oh. A little drippage. That looks pretty good, huh?
Looks like beer, so yeah. Dude, that smells so good.
Mm-hmm. Yum, yum, yum.
All right, now we drink it.
Well.
Chug, chug.
I'm going to fill this up and give this to May. Or at least keep it at her house so I can cook with it when I'm there.
So all this stuff left in the bottom of the pan here, that's...
junk.
It's crazy.
Going?
It's going, I think.
Yeah. It's been a couple years since we put in some on his Kickstarter for this thing. I didn't get the bottom of it.
Yeah, it's funny because I've seen the stuff about it that he was going to be at the Chicago Underground Film Festival, and I wanted to go. Yeah. And then I thought, I convinced you to go, but then I didn't know that you put money in and that we got tickets apparently. Terry,
yeah,
right?
Yeah. We'll call. We'll be fine.
Because it's sold out. Or at least what it says on the internet. Yeah. Which I know that sometimes you got to say that.
Well, you're my plus one.
Well, we made it to Chicago, and I sure had a fun drive, and we did a lot of planning.
Yeah, good planning.
Yep. Should be real easy. Get chairs.
We're here in the theater. The movie's about to begin. Tim's gonna watch it in IMT.
Well, that was excellent, man.
Yeah.
What did you think of that?
That's an important historical document, I feel. I feel like, I'm glad that that's recorded for posterity.
And it was excellently constructed, too.
Yeah.
Did I throw that out to the editor and the Ryan directing it and the... The score was amazing.
The score was fantastic.
Like, and especially, and I'm glad that he told us about that he'd written the songs at the incidental music. Like, I don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah, that whole thing was awesome. There are no left turns allowed here.
There are no left turns allowed here.
Yeah.
Go somewhere else and turn left.
Yeah, we'll turn left in Milwaukee.
We'll turn right and another right and then another right.
Three rights make a left.
Yeah.